Okay, so if, gosh, I don't know what it is, maybe 4-5 years ago, I seen a thing on TV where some people, granted they're probably hungry, it was a survival situation, but they came across a porcupine, and they killed them and ate them, and everybody was surprised. They all said that it tastes like pulled pork, and they liked it. So ever since then, I was like, man, I'll try it, you know, figure I'll try anything once. And although, given that they're out in the woods trying to survive, I'm sure it doesn't taste nearly that good as home. You know how that goes, and they're hungry. But anyway, the other day we're out bird hunting, came across a porcupine, and finally, after all these years of wandering, I was like, oh, now's my chance. So luckily, the dogs didn't get any quills in the face. They cornered under a sagebrush and dispatched it, and now I have it home. It's kind of a weird deer because I've never cleaned or taken care of a porcupine before, so it's kind of a learning experience. But so now what we're gonna do, to be fair, because there isn't a whole lot, although it seems like a lot of people have actually ate them on the internet, there's not a whole lot as far as how, except for one recipe we see that's kind of going around is meatballs. But I mean, that's just ground up bird with seasoning and everything, so everything kind of tastes that way. So we're just gonna do it a smoke on the smoker, and show you what we're gonna do. We're gonna make it very simple, not gonna over season it or rub it, because first time I've ever had it, so really kind of don't know what we're getting into as far as the taste or texture or any of that. But just getting season it here. You can see, you got after we kind of cleaned them out, there wasn't much for, as in the way of the animal, really all together. So but we're gonna basically season, and the one thing I have heard from a lot of people, which is anything else that you cook, is everybody says either cook it in bacon grease or wrap it in bacon, like anything with any other food, you know, chicken or, you know, maybe like a pork fillet, wrap it up, you know, everything is better with bacon. So we're gonna try doing it that way. And figured if nothing else, we got bacon, but we're also going to have chicken we're going to put on a smoker and some crappie. So if all else fails and this is just as absolutely awful, we do have something else to eat. But I don't know, here we go. As far as, you know, there's not a lot of prep because I said I haven't had the porcupine before, so kind of don't know what we're getting into. So we're just going to lighten the season salt with... remember, we're putting this on a smoker, so just kind of get it everywhere there. But this is garlic, pepper, and salt all together in one. Just kind of your three basic seasonings that everybody uses for everything. And then we're going to wrap it up. As far as, like I said, it's kind of new. Don't have any good, you know, if you're cooking elk or bear, you might have a good, you know, hunting story to go with it. Don't really have that with the porcupine. I mean, it's a porcupine, so probably be one of the funniest things, or maybe kind of sad in a way because of how they look, which we learned yesterday when we were kind of cleaning them out. Is a buddy of mine, Ron Kidwell, I'll never forget. You know, I grew up down in Southern Oregon, which is really big in the lumber industry, and they used to have, I don't know if they do anymore, I don't think so, they used to have a bounty on porcupines because they eat all the new trees, that tops off of them and kill all new trees that they put in. So they used to have actually a bounty that they would put on porcupines. And I remember him telling a story where a guy went out and he was actually hunting with his daughters, and he came across one. And of course, I'm not sure how much they even paid out on them. Probably not a whole lot. But I remember him telling a story where he's out with his daughters, and he seen one in a tree, and his daughters are in the truck with them. You know, I think they were deer hunting, but he had seen a porcupine, there's a bounty, and so he shot it, and his little girl asked him, ever so sad, I'm sure, "Daddy, why'd you shoot the monkey out of the tree?" And I always kind of thought that was kind of funny, because, you know, she didn't know, and I always kind of felt bad for that guy that he had to describe to the little girl that why he just shot a monkey out of a tree, or try to explain how it doesn't look like a monkey. And part of the reason that story come to mind is because yesterday we were hanging them, skinning up with this little paws and stuff. As you do skin them, it kind of did look like a little monkey and everything. It's really a different way to be. Different animal altogether. The quills itself, for those of you who don't know, the quills, when I pulled them out, it's weird because it's a fur, but it reminded me more of kind of like feathers than it did anything. So just a really neat animal, actually, but it's just, I don't know, it's one of those freaks of nature, I guess. It's just different too. At the same time, put it on the flat side there. I'm not sure exactly how I'm gonna do this part. We thought about cutting this in half, but it's right down the spine. So we're just gonna leave them whole and kind of do a. Hopefully, you're doing it on a smoker. Gonna be slow and for a while. So maybe when it's all done, it will be more like a kind of pulled pork. We'll see. But I'm sure a lot of you right now are probably laughing because it's, I don't know, from where I'm from, this is a very, what people refer to as a redneck hillbilly kind of thing, and believe me, I realize that. It is to me still kind of too, but you know, I was talking to someone actually just earlier today, because they were laughing because I said, yeah, we're going to eat it, and I am kind of excited, I want to try it out and everything. But it's like, if you were to look at an animal, yeah, it's not by definition an animal that you would think that you're going to eat or that looks tasty. But then again, I mean, you know, the example I'd use is having someone figure out to eat some of the animals we did, and you know, like alligator. Alligator is actually pretty good, but who had the idea that looking at an alligator that, hey, that's an tasty animal, I'm going to get one to eat. And I'm pretty sure that I think it would probably more went like some guy ran across the little one and got bit. And as to teach it a lesson, he probably ate it. He's probably a little bit hungry. He said, you bite me, I'm going to bite you, and ate it. And so it probably, you know, it sounds funny, but it was probably something stupid like that. And the guy tried it and, hey, that's pretty good. I bet there's more meat on a bigger one. And who knows how, you know, we figure out things we're going to eat. So. All right, so that's pretty much done. Let's go put it out on the smoker. All right, so we got a smoker going. Another reason we figured that the good way to be would be to smoke this is because, quite frankly, on these new pellet smokers, it's really hard to screw something up. So even if you do mess up, it should taste about as good as it's gonna taste. And we'll just go ahead. I did put a meat thermometer in it. We're gonna do it for a long time. Hopefully it's tender. It should be tender. It's the meat's kind of hard to explain. If you're wondering, it's actually, it feels like a real delicate meat. So I don't know. He had a lot of fat. We were really surprised how much fat was on it. And it's not a hard fat like on elk or deer. It's kind of more real soft. It's, I don't know, kind of in between something with like beef and, for those of you who know, a bear fat. Kind of interesting, but kind of trimmed it all off. Generally speaking, a wild game fat doesn't usually make it taste good, so better safe than sorry. But we have a meat thermometer in, gonna put it up to, all meat says is good up to 165. We'll probably bring the temperature up a little above that because dealing with an unknown, can't really see any safe temperature, but everything is supposed to be safe at 165. So we're gonna cook it at that and let it sit at that temperature for a little bit before we pull it out. And should be good to go. All right, so been on the smoker now for about 3 hours. Take a look at it. It's looking pretty good. Again, it's been 3 hours. It's not up to temperature where we like it yet. So again, nice thing about pellet grills, can't screw it up, but we do want to get hot. So for another half hour, I'm gonna turn it up to 300, bring it up to temperature, and it should be good. This is similar way I've done chicken and other stuff, and it turns out excellent, so we'll see. So it looks like it's, if you heard me talking earlier when I was talking to Brad, I said it's reminds me a lot of like bear meat. It looks kind of tough. Maybe you could have smoked it a little lower, a lower temperature, but since this is my idea, I'll try it first. I'm not gonna have it, obviously say whether it's good or bad, because I got a bunch of kids there waiting to try. If I say it's bad, they won't try. If I say it's good, they probably both think I'm lying. But
it's good.
You guys are all gonna be pretty surprised, actually. Honestly, I'll say it.
Wait. You just said you weren't gonna tell us if it was good or bad.
But I'm blown away. It tastes like a beef pot roast. That's, don't believe me. I thought it was gonna taste more like bear for the look of it, but that's kind of what I get. I don't know. We're gonna give some to the kids here.
YouTube.
Who's first?
Me! I am!
I am!
Okay, hold on. Okay, go.
Tastes exactly like beef.
I like it.
Tastes like beef, like jerky too.
Like jerky?
Yeah.
Well, it's not that dried out, is it?
Okay, now who can do the dab?
Now, if I told you that was, if I didn't tell you what it was, what would you think it was?
Bear.
Deer.
Elk. Bear.
Elk or deer, elk, bear. All on buffalo.
Buffalo.
But
buffalo.
Buffalo. Look at Grayson's ate all hers. Is it good though? Would you say it's good?
Yeah.
Right?
A wild beast.
Alright. So
snatched it.
There you have it. Kids are more honest than anybody. The kids like it. You know how they're taste buds are. I mean, as adults, we eat a lot of stuff they won't touch, but they all liked it, so.
Now your turn, Brad.
Porcupine must be pretty good. Best part is, comes with its own toothpicks.
Oh my god.
Here's the quills, got yourself toothpicks and a meal. Can't beat that.
Bada-bum!
Porcupine's the way to go, people.